strange things are happening in this quiet Hampshire street.
You need hands to hold someone you care for.
Meet Andrew McKellar.
You need hands to show that you're sincere.
He used to be a bricklayer, but now he uses his hands for a very different purpose, performing miracles.
When I see somebody sick and suffering, I have this overwhelming feeling inside me to reach out and just take their suffering away. To me, it's natural to see people healed.
Andrew says he has a 2-year waiting list. Those who do make it to his waiting room have incredible stories to tell. Many of his patients believe he's cured their cancer.
Andrew puts his hands on your back and you feel tremendous heat.
I feel a lot of heat in his hands.
And he gently drew his hands up my body. And as he did so, the pain went with it.
And from that day onwards, I started to get better.
With Andrew's help, my liver is clear.
I think he's fantastic. I think he's a lifesaver.
Without him, I wouldn't be here now.
Harry.
Hello, Andrew.
Good afternoon.
How are you?
Yeah, fine. Absolutely.
Thank
fine.
You.
Take a seat in any one of the chairs there.
All day long, the faithful and the hopeful arrive at his door. But not everyone is happy with the comings and goings. Andrew started his business here 18 months ago, but he didn't have planning permission. His neighbours were unhappy about the additional traffic, so Fareham Borough Council restricted the hours he can work. That means patients have to wait longer for treatment. It's a decision that's angered the local policeman, PC Dave Spelling.
I've been policing it since Andrew's been here, and I've never seen any congestion. I've certainly not seen hundreds of cars going in and out. He sees about 3 or 4 people an hour.
You know, it's not the first time that the police have come to this lovely and leafy street in Burridge, because opinion here is very much divided. Anonymous letters have been sent complaining about his activities, whilst others have been sent in support. But, you know, everything's gone so much further than letters. There are allegations of dirty tricks, and in fact, in terms of Burridge, things have become pretty unpleasant. But today, the local Bobby isn't here on professional business.
I've got an esophageal tumour, which is the main tumour, and in the last week we've discovered that I've got a walnut-sized brain tumour, which is basically I've become drug-resistant to the regime I was on in London. And because of that, they've taken off all my chemotherapy and basically said there's no more they can do for me medically. So it's basically me and Andrew fighting this thing together, and if he can't cure me, then nobody can.
Well, it's time to feel those healing hands for myself. A 10-minute session like this cost £15. Andrew has no doubt its value for money.
There is no doctor, specialist or surgeon on this planet that can do what this power does that comes through me and comes out of my hands.
Your hands are very definitely hot.
Mm-hmm.
So there's no question that there's a temperature raise there.
Can I just show you my hands now?
Yeah, they feel not very warm, not cold or hot.
Yeah, but when I place them on the back.
Yeah, and I definitely feel more relaxed than I did when I came in. There's no question of that. The whole experience, definitely a de-stressing feeling.
I did feel more relaxed, but I hadn't experienced any miracles. Now, if you'd have asked me, I would have presumed that faith healers were quite a rare commodity, few and far between, on account of the rarity of their gift or their skills. But not in this particular road, because astonishingly, immediately opposite Andrew is another of the same ilk. The funny thing is, no one around here knows that Kim Rose is a healer.
Kim, how long have you been treating people here?
Been treating people here for about 10 years.
10 years? There must have been, you know, tens, hundreds of people coming and going. What have the neighbours made of it?
Well, the neighbours never said anything up until now because they didn't know.
Well, they do now. They've just found out.
Cheers.
Unlike Andrew, Kim is not a professional healer. He helps people after he's finished work, and he never charges for his services. For pensioners like Gwen, that's a godsend.
Jesus Christ never charged nothing to you, neither does Kim. And there's a lot of people out there really, really ill and can't go to people because they can't afford to go.
Charging is not the only difference between the two healers. Kim believes we all have the gift within us, but Andrew disagrees.
No, I don't believe that people can learn how to heal.
I believe that everyone has this power in their mind and in their spirit.
When it comes to healers, many are picked, but few are chosen.
I believe that everyone can help others if they want to.
Miracle workers are rare in this country. It is a rarity to find a natural-born healer.
Now, look, we thought it would only be fair to commission an independent-minded assessment of the relative skills of these two faith-healing gentlemen. So I got my mum along, who's a very independent-minded lady, and my mother-in-law, although we're not actually married yet. Now, Christine, you've had a bad back, and we're talking about serious pain for some time, haven't you?
About 6 years now, yes.
And you've tried all sorts of different things to try and alleviate that?
Quite a few different alternative therapies.
Excellent. Lots of experience, which is what we need. And Mum, since Christmas, well, I've heard all about it.
Yes, I've had very bad pain since Christmas. The doctor said it was wear and tear. And then, following that, they diagnosed it as osteoporosis.
Which is serious.
Very nasty, yes.
OK, well, look, I'd like you to go and see Andrew, who's waiting for you in here.
Yes.
Try a few sessions. Tell us what you think. Mm-hmm. And Christine, Kim is waiting for you over here.
OK.
All right? Good luck. Both healers are confident they can help, but only if they give a full course of treatment. So the ladies will each receive four sessions. Now, it's been 4 weeks since our maternal guinea pigs started coming here for treatment, so I've come along to canvass them, to see what they really made of this. I've got a doorstep, my own mum, on someone else's doorstep. In a nutshell, how was it for you?
I started off by being a skeptic, and during the 4 weeks that I've come to have treatment, I have actually found, to my amazement, that it works. This man has got powers that, you know, are incredible. If this is faith healing, I've got to say there's a great future in it.
Have you got faith in it? Right, okay, the thing is, come on, let's go over the... Christine, I've had my mum's appraisal. What's your own?
I'm not 100% sure. Each week he's honed in on the part where I've got the pain, which really surprised me.
But what about in terms of a cure?
Yes, for a few hours. And then it does, by the next day, it starts to come back again.
Generally quite positive. I remain sceptical. But thanks very much for taking part in our film. We are making another film next week. Would you like to help us?
Yeah. Oh, yes, shall we?
Of course.
Yes.
They are good. Lion Taming for Beginners. Come on.
I'll do something.
If you've experienced unusual cures, we'd like to hear from you on www.bbc.co.uk/insideout.
The connection between crops.